aircraft's orientation relative to the horizon. Look outside. Notice how the cockpit is situated approximately 4 inches below the horizon line. You're flying straight, maintaining a decent rate of speed. This is the cruise attitude. Check to see how it shows up on your instruments. First up, your attitude indicator. This shows your current attitude. The white line is the horizon, and as you'd expect, the sky is above and the ground below. That orange element in the middle is your aircraft aligned with the horizon. As you saw outside, your current cruise attitude is relatively straight and level. Next up, check your tachometer to see how much power the engine's generating. All right, approximately 2,300 revolutions per minute. Attitude and engine RPMs combined translate to aircraft performance. Which leads us to your airspeed indicator. And last but not least, your altimeter. To calculate your altitude, read the small needle first to find out how many thousands of feet up you are. Then read the big needle to figure out the hundreds. With your current attitude and power output, speed is holding steady around 90 knots, altitude is a stable 6,000 feet. But not for long. Take the stick when you're ready. Pull back slightly on the yoke, raising the nose approximately 2 inches above the horizon line. You don't want to pitch up too much. If the angle's too steep, it won't create lift. Without enough lift, the aircraft will stall. Now, go full throttle. Start your climb. Pull back slightly on the yoke, raising the nose approximately 2 inches above the horizon line. You are now in a climb attitude. Check to see how it shows up on your attitude indicator and tachometer. On your altimeter, you can see you're gaining altitude. However, you're losing airspeed, even at full throttle. Not a sustainable situation. Go ahead and bring the aircraft back to a cruise attitude. Ease up on the yoke, aim your nose slightly below the horizon, and reduce your throttle to 2,300 RPMs. That's it. You're set up with the same attitude and power you had at the top of our lesson. Time to move on to the descent attitude. First step is adjusting your power. Reduce your RPMs to 1,800. Next, you'll want to lower the aircraft's nose, just a little farther below the horizon. With a nose-down attitude, it's no surprise altitude is decreasing and speed is on the rise. Now, bring the aircraft back to a cruise attitude. Then we'll be ready for the final part of our lesson. Cruise, climb, and descent. Time to cover the turn attitude. Gently move the yoke left or right to start rolling the plane. A quick look outside will show how your attitude has changed. However, you can also check your instruments for the details. As a general rule, you should always aim to keep your turns under 30 degrees. On your attitude indicator, you'll find a series of notches along the top. Each notch represents 10 degrees. You may notice the more you turn, the more you need to pull back on the yoke to maintain altitude. When you're rolling out, You'll need to do the opposite. Roll and push at the same time. Mastering the main attitudes of flight is an essential step for every pilot in training. You're on your way, but more practice never hurts. Whenever you're done, pass me the controls. Control. Good job.